So now we have a recursive formula for a geometric sequence, which the geometric just means that it's multiplied by something every time instead of having something added or subtracted. My first term is 2, so on part A, when it asks me to find the first 4 terms, I already know my first term is 2 because that's a given. That's what f of 1 means. This is the pattern of what's happening to it, and it says that it's taking the last term I knew and cutting it in half, timesing it by 1/2. So the last term I knew was 2. That's my first term. My second term is 1/2 times 2. My third term is 1/2 times 1. My fourth term is half of that again. So now I need to rewrite these terms in the table. So I know that I just found my first 4 terms. So when x is 1, y is 2. When x was 2, y was 1. When x was 3, y is 0.5. And finally, when x is 4, y is 0.25. Which, since this pattern was an addition and subtraction pattern, and this pattern was a multiplication pattern, you know that this graph is going to make an exponential graph. So you're plotting your points, 1, 2, 2, 1, 3, 0.5, 4, 0.25. You know what's happening right here. This is quickly turning into my asymptote, and it's going to continue going this way. I think I'd like to know when x is 0, what y is, just so I can see how steep it rises. So going this way, if I was cutting it in half, going backward, I'm doubling it. So 2 would double to make 4, so that if I cut the 4 in half, it made 2. So at 0, I'm up at 4. And I could do this another point if I needed to. I could figure out at negative 1 that it was twice this amount, which is 8, just to make sure my graph is exactly where it's supposed to be. Try to connect these as smoothly as possible. So here's my exponential equation. Now to write the explicit formula. My initial value, that's what I had to start with, which is the y-intercept, which we've already figured out, is 4. And we know that it's going to be something to the power of x, and that something is the factor that we use to find the next y value each time, which would be 1/2, which we knew that since 1/2 is less than 1, that this would have been a decay, which is what this shows going down. And now I can use this to find my 8th term. I'm just going to type into my calculator, probably not y equal. I'm going to type in 4 times 1/2 raised to the 8th power. So 4 times 1/2 raised to the 8th power makes a pretty ugly decimal. I'm going to turn that back into a fraction, so math, enter, and it looks like it makes 1/64. So when x was 8, y was 1/64.